I'm Dr. Shobhana Nageshwari. Today's session we are going to see about FPGA, field programmable gate array. In VLSI, we have seen the designs, combinational logic circuit designs, sequential logic circuit designs. After design, we have to come for the implementation part. For the implementation, we need a FPGA. FPGA is field programmable gate array. It is an IC. It will consist of hardware blocks with user programmable interconnects that is used to customize the operation for a specific applications. So we can get as a FPGA as a IC from the vendors that can be customized. That FPGA may be a fully customized IC or a semi-customized ICs. A fully customized IC, we can write our own program. Entire IC can be modified. We can write a programs, we can create our new design and we can implement. Semi-customized means half of the content will be already programmed by the manufacturers. The remaining things will be programmed by the customers. So we are having interconnects can be sometimes already it's programmed, it can be reprogrammed, and FPGA always allows to accommodate the changes. It is easy to redesign. And previously, FPGA uses the PROM, programmable ROM it uses, and PLD structures it uses. Now we are going for the SRAM categories. We are using SRAM, static RAM will be used, or a flash memory used. Because of this, we can easily reprogram it. And FPGA manufacturers are Intel, Xilinx, Lattice Semiconductor, Microchip Technology, and Microsemi. So these are all the familiar manufacturers of FPGA. So FPGA, it consists of CLB. CLB is nothing but configurable logic blocks. And these thousands of CLBs surrounded by a programmable interconnect that is called as a fabric. That routes signals between CLBs. Apart from this CLBs and interconnects, I/O blocks are there. So I/O block, it will interfaces between the FPGA and the external devices. And depending on the manufacturers, CLB can be termed as logic block, logic element, logic cell, or logic module. And FPGA is it is a member of ASIC family. ASIC means application specific ICs. So any particular application, the IC is developed for any particular applications. So it is also a case of ASIC family, and it replaces the TTL logic in a microelectronic system. So FPGA is a gate array structure. And if you see the important characteristics of an FPGA are none of the layers are customized. So a programmer, a buyer can customize each and every layers. And basic logic cells and also interconnect, both are programmable. So logic modules as well as interconnect, both can be easily programmable. And also it can be reprogrammable. And another thing is, we are going to have a logic cells in the array. Rows and columns of logic cells that will be surrounded by interconnects. Using this, we can implement combinational as well as sequential logic. And we are having a matrix of programmable interconnect. So the matrix of programmable interconnect, it will surrounds the logic cells. The interconnects, it will provide the power supply and the ground signals. Like this, each and every required signals will be given through the interconnect. And I/O cells are also there. These I/O cells surround the core. And also, we can design within a few hours. It will be easy to design. FPGA. It stands for the field programmable gate array. These are all very familiar microsystem designs. and we know that we are going to implement thousands transistors within IC. So it comes under the microelectronics, and it will fill the gap between TTL and the PLD design. It's also a kind of a ASIC IC. And normally FPGA consists of PLB, that is programmable logic block, which implement logic functions, and also routing, programmable routing that connects these all these logic functions and IO blocks. Okay, majorly three things are there. That is a logic block, programmable logic block for a logic function, and the programmable routing that connects the logic functions, and the last one is the IO block. That is each and every FPGA will have these three things. So we can see the FPGA architecture. This is the architecture. We can see this is the CLBs, logic block, or a configurable logic block, and these are all the interconnects. These lines are interconnects. The interconnect will have a matrix, that is switch block or a switch matrix. We can see the interconnects, and also the edges, four edges we are going to have in the IO pads. Input output pad we are having this. So this looks like a symmetrical array. So row and column wise CLBs are arranged. This is also a FPGA architecture. We can see here interconnecting wires and switch matrix. So IO bank, CLB, either it may be a logic block, logic cell, configurable logic block, or a logic module. So what is this use of the switch matrix? Means using this, we can connect any one of the particular CLB. So if you are using only a particular area of the CLB, means the other CLB will not be in the working condition, it will be in the sleep mode. So because these switch matrix, it won't be on, so it won't create the connections. So only these things will be, these things particular things will be on. So switch matrix is used to turn on particular CLBs. So that is the advantage of the CLBs. So another IO banks will be in that edges. So this is a FPGA logic block. So we can see here CLB. Each CLB is having this structure. LUT, LUT, lookup table. Input will be given to the lookup table, and a flip-flop MUX arrangement. This is the FPGA logic block. So the entire architecture will be like this. This is the FPGA architecture. So these things will be CLBs, or logic blocks will be arranged like this. And this is the IO block, the edges we are having IO block, and this is the programmable routing. And the types of FPGAs, we can classify the FPGA based on the applications. So we are going to have three kinds: low-end FPGA, mid-range FPGA, and high-end FPGA. So low-end FPGAs will be designed for low power consumption and low logic density and low complexity. So examples, we can have this Cyclone family from Altra, and the Spartan family from Xilinx, Fusion family from Microsemi, and the Mac from Lattice Semiconductor. So depends upon the need. It may be we can purchase the low-end FPGA, mid-range, or high-range. So each and every range will vary for the cost. So depends upon our need, we can go for the low-end FPGA or a mid or high-end FPGA. So high-end will have that is developed for the high logic density and for high performance. Examples, we can say Stratic family from Altra and Vertex family from Xilinx. If you see the Vertex family, it will have many options. You will have a camera, high-end camera, like this, the image easily we can convert into the, we can dump into the ICs. Like that, so many facilities will be available with the Vertex board. But the Spartan board, we don't have the camera facility at all. And the Speedster 22i family, and we are having a Pro ASIC 3. These are all the high-end FPGAs. So we are having in between low and high, we are having a mid-range. that is for especially it is developed for the performance as well as the cost. So example we can say Aria from Altra and Arctic series from Xilinx and IGL002 from Microsemi. So like this from also from Lattice Semiconductor. These are all the familiar manufacturers of FPGA. So depends upon the need requirement, customers can choose the low end or high end mid range FPGAs. So we have discussed about the FPGA, what is FPGA, architecture of FPGA and the classifications, types of FPGA we have seen in this video. The next video we will see about the CLB, configurable logic blocks in detail.